Ladies and gentlemen, we introduce the power electronic interfaces as important elements of AC and DC microgrids, which are in the forms of AC to DC, DC to DC, DC to AC, or AC to AC converter. In this video, we give a brief overview on the conversion from AC to DC, which is rectification, and the inversion from DC to AC. The main learning objectives will fall under two main questions. Firstly, what are the possible topologies for AC to DC and DC to AC converters for both single and three-phase AC system? And secondly, how are these power converters operating? Let's first start with the conversion from AC to DC in a single-phase AC system. The single-phase AC can be converted to the DC voltage through a diode rectifier, which consists of four diodes and two legs. The input AC voltage, VAC in, is converted to the output DC voltage, VDC output, as it is shown in the figure. When the input voltage is positive, then diodes D2 and D3 turn on. Of course, we know the diodes are conducting when the voltage on the anode is positive with respect to the cathode. On the other hand, when the input voltage is negative, diodes D1 and D4 will be conducting. Therefore, always a positive voltage is reflected at the DC link. The figure below shows the input sinusoidal AC voltage, VAC in, and the output voltage, VDC output, as well as the output current, IDC output. If the load is purely resistive, then the average output DC voltage is approximately equal to the input effective efficient value of the AC voltage multiplied by 0.9. The average of the output DC current, EDC, IDCF, and the average of the DC voltage, VDCF, are shown where the relative ratio depends on the resistance of the load. Note that typically a capacitor is placed at the output of the diode bridge in order to reduce the output voltage ripple. Due to the use of diodes, which can conduct the current only in one direction, this rectifier can only allow the unidirectional flow from power from the AC to DC. Now, we focus on the conversion from AC to DC in a three-phase AC system. Similarly to the single-phase converter, the three-phase AC can be converted to DC through a three-leg diode rectifier, including six diodes. Depending on the values of the line-to-line voltages, VAB, VBC, and VAC, two diodes in two different legs conduct the current. Note that the equations on the right-hand side show how the line-to-line voltage are calculated based on the single-phase to ground voltages. The output DC voltage and average DC current are represented by VDC output and IDC average. In the figure below, we present three-phase line-to-line voltages that have 120 degrees phase shift. The average output voltage of three-phase diode rectifier, VDC average, and the average DC current are shown. As it can be seen, there are some ripples in the output voltage that is much lower than the ripple of the previously shown single-phase diode rectifier. If the load is purely resistive, then the average of the DC voltage is approximately equal to 1.35 times of the line-to-line voltage. After presenting two AC to DC topologies, let's have a look into the DC-AC inversion, where one of the simplest electronic devices to invert the input DC voltage V in to the output single-phase AC voltage V out is the so-called half bridge. The half bridge consists of two capacitors in one leg on the left-hand side and two switches in another leg on the right-hand side. If the switch S1 is on, as it is shown in the figure on the right, then the positive value of half of the input voltage is across the load. Note that while switch S1 is 1 during the first half period, from 0 to T divided by 2, the switch S2 is on during the second half of the period, T divided by 2 to T. In this case, during the first half period, the current flows through the switch to the load. The switch S2 is on during the second half of the period, as it is shown in the figure on the right. During this second time of the period, as it is shown in the figure on the left, the half of the input voltage with negative polarity is connected to the load, where these polarities are shown in red. In this example, we assume that the load is inductive, for which we analyze the output voltage and current. The figure shows the output AC voltage, V output, which is equal to positive input voltage V in, divided by 2 during the first half of the period, and to negative V in, divided by 2 during the second half of the period. The output current is shown in the curve in orange, representing an inductive load. Because of inductive load, there is a phase shift between the voltage and current, and diodes antiparallel with the switches are conducting. For example, when S1 switches off, the positive current is through the diode antiparallel to S2. Note that in a half bridge, the maximum amplitude of the AC voltage is equal to the half of the input DC voltage. The previously introduced half bridge can be further enhanced by replacing two capacitors with two switches to create a full bridge DC-AC converter. Therefore, the full bridge consists of 4 switches and 2 legs. Similar to the half bridge, the two switches S1 and S2 and S3 and S4 in one leg turn in the first and second half of the period respectively. The ground point is shown where the input DC voltage is divided by 2 across each capacitor. To calculate the voltage difference, VAN, we subtract the voltage at the point between S1 and S2 in the first leg from the voltage of VN. If N is the grounding point, then VN in this equation is equal to 0. Similarly, to obtain the voltage difference VAB, we subtract the voltage at the point B between S1 and S2 in the first leg from the VN. As a result, the output AC voltage, which is equal to the difference of the voltages at points A and B, can be calculated by subtracting VAN from VBN. Let's now have a look at a more detailed operation of a single-phase DCAC inverter. The figure on the left shows the single-phase DCAC inverter with the point N. The figure on the right above shows two signals which are used to create proper signals using the so-called unipolar switching pulse with modulation. The first one is a triangle signal, V triangle, that has the frequency at the switching frequency. The second one is the sinusoidal control signal, V control, and the minus of V control with the fundamental frequency. The figure on the right in the middle shows the phase to neutral voltages of phase A. When the triangle voltage is lower than the V control, then S1 is on, and accordingly VAN is equal to the V input, V in. The other figure on the right middle shows the phase to neutral voltage of phase B. If the value of V tri is less than the minus V control, then the switch S3 turns on, and therefore the phase to neutral voltage VBN is equal to the V in. If we subtract VAN from VBN, then the line-to-line output voltage V output, VO, is obtained as shown in the figure on the right below. The fundamental sinusoidal component, which is VO1, is also shown in the figure. The single-phase DCAC inverter can be controlled using the pulse width modulation, PWM. If we properly vary the pulse width, then it is possible to control the output frequency. As it is shown from the figure above to the figure below, the frequency of the AC signal is, for instance, increased. Moreover, with the changes in the pulse width, it is possible to control the amplitudes of the voltage too. Let's now briefly discuss a three-phase DC-AC inverter, which includes 6 switches and 3 legs. The line-to-line three-phase AC voltages are shown for phase AB, BC and AC. These switches provide a large degree of flexibility and can be controlled in such a way that they satisfy a wide range of requirements like the unity power factor or reduced harmonics. Thanks to the antiparallel diodes of the switches, the inverter can allow the bidirectional flow of the power. In this video, we gave an overview of DC to AC and AC to DC converters for single-phase system as well as the three-phase AC connections. It was discussed that in the simplest form, diode rectifiers can be used to convert AC to DC. However, there is no control over the power and no bidirectional power capability flow. Alternatively, fast switches can be used that provide a high level of control and flexibility for both single and three-phase connections. Therefore, we covered both AC-DC conversion and DC-AC conversion. We analyzed in detail the operation of the single-phase DCAC inverter using unipolar PWM switching.